बोले।
After very long gap, we are going to interact with each other. Me, Dr. Sunil Kumar Chaudhary, bio teacher for standard 8, conducting an online class. So welcome to this class in 8. A number of chapters are given. The first chapter is circulatory system in human beings. You know, human beings are the multicellular organism consisting of millions of the cells. So it is a very complex matter to supply nutrients and oxygen to each and every cell, tissue, and organs. So there is a very specific system that is the circulatory system. What is system? System is a device in which different components, different organs work together in a very systematic order, in a proper way, to bring about a very specific task. You know, every living system need energy, and that energy is provided by the oxidation of carbohydrates. It takes place in our cell with the help of oxygen. But how oxygen is supplied to the cell? In multicellular organisms like the human beings, oxygen is taken through our nostril, and it is then reaches to the lungs. From the lungs, it is sent to the different cells and tissues through blood. The blood flows throughout the body in a very specific network of tubules, pipelines. These tubules and pipelines, that is the blood vessels. Blood vessels in which the blood flows in closed circuit. Sometimes you feel if you have any sort of cut, then there is the bleeding. All of a sudden, blood come out due to that cut. Why? Because our circulatory system is closed circuit. So there is the network of the blood vessels closed in which blood flows. But how it takes place? Blood is pumped regularly by our heart. That heart is a muscular organ in which the blood collected and rhythmically supplied to the different parts through the circulatory system. In our body, circulatory system is also divided into two types, that is the blood circulatory system and lymphatic system. So we are here concerned with the blood circulatory system, and I also compare the blood circulatory system with the lymphatic system. So our circulatory system majorly consisting of three components: blood vessels, blood, and human heart. Blood, you know, very important material, substance. So we must know what is blood. How can we define it? Blood is a fluid connective tissue. Fluid, that means it flows. So such substance which flows known as fluid. Connective means which connects the different parts of the body. Tissue, you know the tissue is a group of cells. Blood is also a group of cells. Blood having two major parts. One the cellular parts, another the liquid part. The cellular parts further divided into three categories. One that is the red blood cells, second the white blood cells, and the third one platelets. So all together they form the blood. Where it all these cells remain, all these cells remain in the liquid like substance that is plasma. The major part of the plasma made up of water, containing a number of proteins, different types of the substances, nutrients. Each type of the cells, like the erythrocytes, red blood cells, white blood cells, the leukocytes, platelets, that is the thrombocytes, having a very specific function. Erythrocytes, that is small inside, when it get mature, then there is no nucleus. But initially, they have the nucleus. As the time passes, the amount of hemoglobin, a very specific type of protein, get deposited into the red blood cells, and slowly the nucleus is pushed aside, and finally the nucleus perishes. So nucleus is replaced by the hemoglobin. This hemoglobin is a very specific type of protein, iron containing protein. Heme stands for the iron, and globulin is a type of protein, together forming the hemoglobin. This hemoglobin carry oxygen. How? So when the oxygen come in contact with the red blood cells, hemoglobin picks it and carry up to where it is needed. So oxygen that is sent to the different parts, sent to the different organs, tissues, with the help of erythrocytes. The number of the erythrocytes are large, but at the same time, WBC of larger size having lesser number, very less in comparison to the erythrocytes. Erythrocytes that carry the oxygen, but in return it also carry carbon dioxide. But the WBC, these are the nucleated cells having very specific nucleus, having large size. All the WBCs further divided into two main categories: granulocytes, agranulocytes. Granulocytes further divided into three categories. That is, the under the granulocytes, the first one, the acidophils, basophils, and neutrophils. With the help of nucleus, we can recognize it. Their nucleus is different. At the same time, the agranulocytes, that is monocytes, lymphocytes. So under the granulocytes, the WBC categorized into the acidophils or eosinophils, basophils, and the neutrophils. Then come to the blood platelets. You know the blood platelets, very small cell. It is a fraction of cell. And almost this fraction of cell sometimes having nucleus and sometimes non-nucleus, but play a very important role in blood clotting. You know, whenever any sort of the cut we have, it is the thrombocytes and the platelets come forward and help in the blood clotting by releasing certain enzymes, certain factors. So very important. So each type of the blood cells having a specific function. Plasma, that provide the ground substance in which all the blood cells remain there. Now, the blood vessels, you know, the tube-like structure through which the blood flows. The blood vessels further divided into arteries, veins, capillary. Arteries are the vessels which carry blood away from the heart to the different parts, while the veins carry back the blood from the different parts of the body to the heart. But you know, the blood circulatory system is a closed circuit. So where they meet, the arteries where they end, they form a network, very fine network of the tubules. Then again reunite and then forming the veins. So in between the arteries and the veins, there is a very fine network of the tubules, that is the capillaries. In our body, it is found in each and every organs, but through the diagram, you can see it on the screen. So blood vessels, arteries, veins, and capillaries. Sometimes the questions that is given from this section, what are the difference between the arteries and the veins? When you go through the diagrams, you will see the how the arteries and veins are made up of. You can see here, in arteries, the lumen is small, while in veins, the lumen is large. You can see here, in arteries, their wall is thick, lumen narrow, having narrow diameter, while in veins the wall is thin and the lumen is large, means the large diameter. A number of points also through which we can differentiate between the arteries and veins. The main work of the artery to carry blood from heart to the different parts of the body, while the veins bring back the blood from the different parts of the body to the heart. But there is exception also. The single exception of this rule, the pulmonary artery. You can see here, the pulmonary artery carry impure blood from heart to the lungs for purification, while the pulmonary vein carry blood from pure blood from lungs to the heart. So in general, artery carry pure blood from heart to the different parts, but the pulmonary artery carry impure blood. The veins, in general, carry impure blood, but the pulmonary vein carry pure blood from the lungs to the heart. So a number of points that can easily be differentiated between the arteries and the veins. You can cite the arteries are here, you can see the artery having high pressure while the blood having low pressure. The artery having no valves while the veins having valves. The arteries are deeply seated while veins are superficially. That means superficial means just below the upper skin layer. So a number of difference you can cite. In total, the blood having certain functions. Blood is a liquid connective tissue, a fluid connective tissue performing the following functions. In general, the blood carries oxygen from lungs to the different parts of the body and removes carbon dioxide from the body cells. So when there will be the respiration, oxygen is utilized, the carbohydrate is broken down, the carbon dioxide is produced. So that carbon dioxide should be removed. It is also carried by the blood. The blood carries digested food from the intestine to the all parts of the body for its proper utilization. Blood contains WBC, which protects the body from diseases. So WBC provides us immunity, fight with the pathogens. Different WBC having different functions. Blood carries hormones from the endocrine glands. Here the endocrine glands, you know, the glands having no ducts, to the different organs for function. Blood carries a waste products called the urea from the liver, where it is produced, and from there to the kidney for its removal, and this process is known as excretion. Blood regulates body temperature also. The blood contains platelets, which form a clot around bone, thus preventing blood loss. So a number of functions in general the blood do. Now the you can see the different slides in detail. So this is the end of today's class. In the next class, we will discuss more. Thank you. See you again.